Do you want to complete the Dark Prince draft challenge like me? Do you want to add an exciting new emote to your collection? Then let me give you tips to achieve that. Hello everyone, my name is King Awesome, and today we have the Sad Face Dark Prince draft challenge. Yeah, I know it's long. I guess Supercell ran out of ideas and for the name. Okay, with that aside, I'm going to help you get the sweet emote by highlighting a couple tips. I promise that if you follow these, you shall certainly complete the challenge. Tip number uno. Always make sure to get a win condition. You should probably have at least one win condition. It will be a card that can win you the game. If you don't have one, you'll find yourself in a stance where your pushes will be just baseless. You won't even have something to punish your opponent if he plays a high elixir card. So yeah, make sure you pick at least one. Here are a couple of them. These are the most popular according to the matches that I played. The numbers represent the number of times I encountered them throughout the 11 matches which I played. Tip number 2. Always choose the counter. If you choose the counter, you'll usually end up having a positive elixir trade. Like suppose if you get a choice to pick Skeleton Army or Log, you should definitely pick the Log. Tip number 3. Always pick the Royal Recruits whenever you can and never the Elixir Golem. The Royal Recruits are really good in the challenge. That's because they're just gonna split up and be able to defend both sides easily. They're just gonna cover the entire map. Following this, never pick the Elixir Golem. This is a very perilous pick as the opponent will be able to punish you badly if you have bad supporting cards or weak defensive cards. If your opponent is able to counter the Elixir Golem, you'll be in big trouble as he just accumulated 4 Elixir, which will be hard for you to stop. Also, you should consider picking Battle Ram or the Ram Rider as they'll be good on both offense and defense. Tip number 4. Pick high damage spells. Sometimes it so happens that even after having a win condition, no player seems to be breaking through. This is where these spells are gonna be extremely needed. The most common spell that I have seen by far is the Rocket. So pick it whenever you can. You can also consider picking spells that work well with the cards you've chosen. Like for example, if you've picked the Balloon, then you should probably pick Freezer Arrows or something that complements it well. Tip number 5. Always put up a good defense and avoid rushing. In this challenge, there are no meta decks, so you have zero idea of what cards the opponent has. So don't end up rushing with Lumberjack Balloon without knowing what counters the opponent has. If the opponent has Minion Horde, you're doomed. And then the player can also punish you badly for spending 9 elixir. So remember not to overcommit on offense. Better be safe than sorry. One more thing to note is that in every match there will be a Dark Prince. Either you or your opponent will have it. Therefore avoid picking ground swamps unless you are 100% certain that you have the Dark Prince. And with that, we are done with all the tips I have for you guys today. I'm just gonna leave you guys to spectate this awesome match. I'm already done with the challenge thanks to these tips, and now you too certainly will. Thanks for watching and subscribe for more awesomeness.